Hey guys, what's up? Sora here, and this is a sets video. First to 10 against Discovigilante, Playin, and Bison. He hit me up on Twitter asking because he wanted to show his friends an example of a Karin Bison match, and he wanted himself, and I guess that was the first Karin that went to his mind. More than happy to oblige. Especially, of course, I'm not as familiar with this matchup as I should be. So I figured it's a good learning opportunity for me, it's a good learning opportunity for you guys watching this video. I might get bodied, just forewarning. I don't think I will, but he's definitely good. Now, one of the things about Bison Karin is that, at the very least, it's the lower levels, or if you talk to just any Karin Bison, they'll say that each one doesn't have a good end. Which is true to an extent, but I'm trying to play a little bit smarter than that, so to speak. So we're both trying to whiff punish each other. He's using his fireball to whiff punish. I'm using my standing whiff, my medium kick to whiff punish. Nice. And that's unfortunate, that doesn't reach right there. That's gonna hurt stuff. No punish on my part. Nice. That's gonna be a lot of damage. This has a standard blood. Afraid of the slide. If I went for a standing medium kick, it would have worked, but I didn't have super, so I really wasn't going to gain anything, even if that had hit. Nice, nice punish on that part. Nice. He has caught me dashing every single time. He's either watching for it or something. Accident. Nope. He was walking back. I thought he was gonna walk forward. He's not really committing, which is smart. He doesn't really need to, that's the thing. Thought I was gonna press out a button. Nope. Too far for the punish. Don't know why he got counter hit there. I had to spend the super. There was no other way that I was gonna kill him from half-life. That's the one advantage that Karin has in this. He can shimmy Bison to death, pretty much. Or she can shimmy Bison to death. But he has been doing a good job. I just practically stole that, really. Nice! That's a good setup. Not minus 4. He can disrespect that. Because that's only plus 1, and he doesn't have a 3-frame jab, you can disrespect any plus 1 move he has with your own 3-frame jab. Again, another one of Bison's weaknesses, so to speak. Yeah, that's unfortunate. It's a gimmicky setup, what I just did there. If he was crouching, that grab would have worked. Because he was standing, he had a narrow hitbox, so the grab whiffed. Unfortunately, he reacted with a grab, so I kind of got a semi-shimmy out of it. A pseudo-shimmy, so to speak. And it's really, really gimmicky. I don't really like doing it. Recently, when I train, I actually don't bother going for Oki setups. Because I find them very gimmicky. The reason why I'm doing this is because I'm training him. I'm not necessarily just training myself. Or training whoever his friend is. that wants advice on this matchup. I'm trying to also state as much info as I can for this matchup so he knows what to do with it. I'm gonna lock back into me. Nice. Nice. Nope, doesn't reach. Ooh. I reacted a little bit too late to the dash. He's gonna blow his load? Yeah. Half-life. Surprised he didn't dash in. Now he dashed in. Very plus. I figured it was worth it. Ah! I'm trying to do the Justin Shingy. Which is the second level where you forward, back, forward, back. But I haven't gotten the timing quite down yet. Minus 4. I don't think so. I'm curious on how much damage this will do. I don't think it'll do a lot. No. Even off the fierces. Can disrespect it. Can disrespect it. The only time where he gets at it is if he gets it in medium far range. I don't really have to press the button here. Force the issue. Wow. Nice counter of view reversal. That was actually dangerous. If he had woken up super, I would have totally respected it, by the way. But I shouldn't have pressed the jab when he dashed in that last time. Nice. Can't press jab there, it's too far. Vega can. If thy name was Vega, maybe, but... only plus one. I really shouldn't be doing that strength. Should be doing like light lights instead. And that's okay. I went for a grab, but it didn't come out by the time. I thought I could walk under. That's what I was going for. If he didn't walk back, I'm like, I thought it was enough time to just dash up a medium punch. But as soon as I dashed up the first time, he was already walking back. I'm like, oh crap, my medium punch is gonna whiff, so I double dash and of course he reacts accordingly. These are good matches. Let's see what my adjustment is. I really don't like jumping, at least right now. I'll explain in another video, or probably by this time, the time this goes up, I would have already explained. But essentially, I feel that that's my downfall as a player, that I'm afraid to play footsies. Should confirm that. I fell. You should. Hey, you have a little bit more time to react to Bison's dash, but you still have to guess. It can't be a raw reaction, especially online. Yeah. That's unfortunate. Nice guess. Too late. I should have done, Justin now used it recently in Manila Cup, but what you can do is on their wake up, you can just backdash. You have to go right up to them, backdash, and then do crouching forward. You avoid their throw, you avoid a lot of jabs, really. A lot of wake up jabs, and you either make them block or punish whatever button they press on wake up. He likes the fadeaway medium kick, I'm noticing. So I can't really move forward to low forward turn. That's probably why he's doing it too. I did wake up DP, did not come out. Thought they would block that. Oops. No, not enough. Nope, not enough. Hit her super after V trigger, as you guys might probably know at this point. It'll scale down quite a bit, so that would have killed if it was a little bit more raw. But it wasn't, so. Could have confirmed the super there. I still have a hard time determining minus four versus the minus two scissors. The light is minus four, the medium is minus two. Need there we go. Speed trigger. Richard kill. Option select. Nice catch. Nice punish again. Nice tech. He spent all his bar, but that was definitely worth it for him to keep the round going. Nice press. Nice challenge. He knows I'm looking for the low forward, that's why he's playing at this perfect range. Nice! Nice callback on the dash. He's gonna slide. Oh my gosh, that's unfortunate. I should have committed. I didn't react in time. I really should have committed. I did not. Well, at the very least, it was the right thing to do. It just didn't work out. So, I'm good with that. As long as it was the right thing to do. I'm getting the right lead, so which means if it doesn't work online, it's gonna work offline, so. But I am getting stopped by that standing medium kick of his. I still haven't figured out how quite to stop it. And I am not reliably anti-airing that, unfortunately. I like pressing a button after getting hit by low-medium kick. Maybe I can take advantage of that. Because I can do low-medium kick into low crouching roundhouse. That should get a crush counter if he pressed the button after. Nice pick throw. Or what Bison defines as a pick throw. I think it crossed off my dash input actually. Nope, he did not press the button that time. Okay. Bad idea. not quite in kill range yet. I thought he was gonna dash one more time because I backdash. I demonstrated a backdash. But I don't know if he actually reacted to just me command dashing. If he did, that was great. I'm gonna spend the super early. Especially if you land it with Fierce, it's a good idea to spend super early because the scaling is so great in your favor. And you have the rest of the second round to build bar. It's one of the two theories in terms of meter build. He that was the anti-jump setup that he did. I'm okay waiting here. Because he's the one running out of V-trigger, I'm not. So. No super from him. Yeah, so, like there, a lot of players panicked in that scenario, and he was trying to make me panic, and you didn't. Because I had the life lead, and his V-trigger was running out, so I don't really need to, commit. Good to know that jab-jab doesn't work. Not the worst decision. This is different from the other one because there's gonna be a lot of scaling right there. So it's not as much damage for bang fair of up, so to speak. But I'm not using the meter to anti-air anyway. Ooh. He moved back way farther than I thought he would. A little bit too much walk forward on my part. I thought he would dash in. That's why that was enough back. I thought he would dash in. I'm like, he's gonna dash in or either a knee, which would beat out either one of those options, and he didn't. So that's good. That was a good new option in his part. He didn't really demonstrate the shimmy crouching low. He always demonstrated like shimmy knee, because of course that leads to a lot of damage, and at worst they're plus whatever it is, plus 4, plus 5, something ridiculous like that. Nice. Dash? No dash. Now it's demonstrating the pro option, which is great. It should be the adjustment on his part. It's unfortunate that the oh wow, it doesn't reach him! Maybe there's a lock forward there. That's the Mago setup. Where you cut the Gorenken short. I'm not believing my shimmies, I don't know why. I don't know why, I thought he was gonna Devil's Reverse. That's why he was like, ah, just block while he's gonna Devil's Reverse. Nope, round just two. Go for a regular stomp. Plus. Wow, that did not kill. I thought that would kill. He can actually disrespect that. I don't know if the friend is a Bison player or a Karin player, but he can actually disrespect that because that's only zero. He can disrespect it to some extent. I doubt that a lot of Karin, at a certain range, the crouching jab will whiff after they block the crouching short. So you can, to some extent, you have to lab it out, but it's only zero. It's not a plus move or anything like that. Try to punish with. Sorry, I'm leaving, being silent. I'm trying to adjust to this play, and it's really, really different, so to speak. Nope, cannot dash under. I've always wondered whether you can dash under that. That was the right call, just way too far a read. Ah. Downing my ranges. That I really couldn't end here anyway. Ooh, maybe I'll try to hard read that this time. The one time that I'm like, oh, he's not sliding, of course he's sliding. Like, I've been baiting that slide, if you guys have noticed, for God knows so many matches now, and that's the one time he does it, so. These are good matches, I'm learning a lot. Despite what the score says, I believe that I am putting up a better fight than I thought I would. I'm just not able to close it out. Oh, I thought for sure that hit. Nice. It's surprising that he chooses me there. There it is. Thought he would commit to something a little bit stronger than that. He did not. Worth it. I'll fight for it. This is literally an anybody scenario. Thought I could make him react. He did not react. Online gimmick. To be fair, that is the one and only time I chose to do that. This entire set. And that's probably the one and only time you guys will see that. Sometimes you have to play the disrespect card. I thought it was a crouching. If it was crouching, crouching fierce, that would have hit. Nice. Yeah. Also, get rid of the flash. I would have supered. When I did the first Orochi, I'm like, wait, he doesn't have any V trigger. I should have just supered to trip out. So, bad on me for recognizing that play. Oh, come on, I love this. Thank you. Bad on me for recognizing it that late. But I should have recognized that way earlier. So,
round one.
On the subject of disrespect, though, that is the one thing that I am also trying to figure out in Absolute Battle, from Absolute Battle, because I felt that I gave a lot of respect to players. When I didn't really need to, you know what I'm saying? What? Because I played like standard. I played by the textbook. And when you play by the textbook, it becomes really, really easy for your opponent to predict what they're about to do. So, yes, playing smart and playing safe is good, but sometimes you have to... Even the pros mash out DP. Even Daigo mashes out DP, despite getting punished. Oh wow, that actually hit that far. I thought he would, that was actually a bad jump. I take that back. That was really a bad jump. That was really- I expected him to jump the first. That's why I went for that already, but, that was a little bit too much prediction on my part. Did not mean that. That was just supposed to be a standing medium kick, which is unfortunate. No, not quite. He's going to take the grab there. That's unfortunate. So I knew that his stun meter was up, so he was going to be afraid of the throw. But I wasn't sure because I've been missing my shimmies, that's why I went for that throw at the end anyway. So that's the reason behind that whole shenanigan move. I'm trying to play smarter. It's only in the corner where Karin becomes really dumb, and even in the mid-screen she becomes really, really dumb. But I'm trying to avoid the mid-screen gimmicky setups. The corner setups, that's in your repertoire, and that should be a reward for cornering someone. Then that's that time. Just a true blocker, keeping him honest. There's his true blocker, keeping me honest. Sand jab does not work there. That was, I had to read that he was gonna go down to first, that's why I was like, okay, just dash forward, and it worked out. Nope. Keep the pressure. That's the reward Karin gets. That little setup right there is one of probably 3-4 reasons why Karin is a top tier character. She gets a genuine 50-50 reset in the corner without spending meter. So that's the very dangerous part of Karin, to be honest. That her standing medium kick, which I'm gonna start using. Let's see if I can adjust my play before I adjust the mine. And of course he jumps in the moment I decide to play footsies. Even though that I got the counter right there, I can't really do anything unless I commit to the counter. I can't do like a standing medium punch into low forward like you normally would in a counter scenario. I can only do probably their medium punch into standing forward because the block standards. Whoa! Nope, I can't. I can probably only do low medium punch into standing forward. That's probably the only thing that will reach it. Normally, that should beat it. Nope, too late. Which is definitely worth it at this point. That's gonna be a lot of damage, especially off the crush counter. Very, very tempting. Next time he misses his axe, I'm just gonna walk forward grab. Ah, shenanigans. Yes, maybe? Oh my gosh! This character's damage. Oh my gosh. This character's damage is insane. Nice. Preemptive axe in order to stop the walk forward. Anti-jump, check. Oh! Okay, well, there's your attack. Whoever you are, there's your attack. That's really, really good. Really, really good attack. I might actually cut that. At this point, it's 4-6, I'm gonna cut that to make sure that there's some anti-V trigger tech for Bison against Karin. Because normally this is a horrendous matchup for Bison.
Round one. Fight!
That's the unfortunate part of using Standing Fierce as a shimmy tool. You actually put yourself back in the grab range during the startup. Nice. Wow, that is the first throw that he has broke. That's the first time I did the throw and that's the first time he broke it. Nice. Not gonna fall for that twice. I actually did low roundhouse into V trigger to make it safe, but I'm not sure why that did not come out. Did that a little bit too close, man. Nope, that doesn't work. I think I should lab the punish out to that, whatever the punish is. In reach too. Unfortunate. I read that too. I didn't believe it. I'm like, he's gonna dash up here. And I didn't believe it. That was if you guys see the replay, my hand was definitely hovering over the standing heavy kick. But I didn't believe it, so it's all good. He's definitely adjusting to my play. And add to the fact that he's getting a little bit he's getting the better end of the scramble.
Round one.
So I think I need to go back to just standing medium kick, honestly. Play at a little bit of a max range of my standing medium kick. The unfortunate part is that's also the max range of his axe, but as long as I don't let any jumpings in, I should be better off this trade. Not the worst jumping in the world. This gets blown up by slide, unfortunately. He has not caught on to that yet. Yeah, see? That only works if your jumpings are solid, and mine are not. And he does have I have the rage advantage. I do not have any sort of combo advantage off standing medium kick. He has an entire BNB that he gets off that. Unfortunate, again. Second time to hit. I should have, as soon as I whipped the crouching medium kick, I should have just gone for heavy kick. That was my only way back. Don't know why I didn't commit that. I'll take the trades. Not that good. I should have spent a super, honestly. The meter efficiency and all that. Well, my only way back. If I don't spend it now, I'm never gonna get another chance. One throw away. Yeah, he has slide, so I actually cannot play at slide distance at this point because he will slide V-trigger. So, what's my way in here? Yeah, see? He has slide. He has a risk-free slide, so either I needed to guess slide, and he wasn't gonna do slide just from that range, or something. And as I was thinking, of course he slides. So I need to learn how to bait out slide. That would be neutral jump, conventionally speaking, but my head was at a totally different play line.
Fight!
So, a piece of tech, if you're the Karin player, piece of tech is if they instant wake up after your forward grab on at the corner, you can do standing light punch at the first frame. It's, I believe, a frame on meaty, and then which then makes it normal link into a standing medium punch. Should not let him jump. Waiting the entire time for me to jump. Next time he scissors, I need to be reversal. And I think I will have enough time for another. I knew it. That was my answer. I knew it. He didn't really have to do anything, that was 9 seconds. So all he had to do was just chill, really. Nice punish. Nice! That's scary. That's actually scary that he can do that. When you have so many things that you're looking for. I'm gonna just grab, just get out of the corner. Nope. Not again, he says. Not again. Because. Okay, now I have to play defensively. I was going for the punish, and of course he goes for the one that blows up dash. So, I think I'm just getting out damage at this point. We're both landing the same amount of hits, so he just has more damage behind his hits. So I need to be a little bit more defensive than what I've been playing as, because I can't really trade blows with the axe, especially with my lower life. If I did the dash earlier, then I would have blown that up. Yeah, this match, you cannot play Putty's Advice and if you cannot anti-air. Just remember that. If nothing else from the set, remember that. Nice set, again. I thought that I should have lost already. So I'm gonna do fireball. Okay. I thought that it's like he's gonna do fireball, that's my only way in. Nope. He did not. Good games, Mr. Discovigilante. So like I said, in this match, whoever anti-airs better wins. Karin has an advantage up close, Bison has an advantage up far, because he trades damage really, really well. Karin has to outright beat him. Like, the games and rounds that I did win, I beat him straight. Like, there was no trading, because Karin cannot trade. Karin cannot trade the Bison. I will lose. His axe, if you can interrupt it, which is one thing that I'm not as good at, because my instinct goes to defense when I see the startup of the axe rather than trying to interrupt it with like a standing medium kick. So that's number one. Number two, you always have to play at that range where you can counter any of his jump in. EX stomp, sure, probably not, because he can reverse course in that easily. The three times I think that I got blown up was from dashing forward when he did EX stomp into the EX doubles reverse. But normal stomp into normal reverse, you can do that and it's free. Like, you should never ever ever be getting hit by normal stomp at all, on the ground at least. The last thing I'm gonna say is just focus on that. It's very, very tempting to jump into Bison, and you may get wins, but you're not gonna learn. You're not gonna learn how to play footsies, honestly, against it. A lot of the best Bisons out there, Tampa Bison, and Discovigilante to an extent, can and will blow you up for it. So, for anyone that's watching this video, if you are playing against Bison, yeah, sure, you can jump. Yeah, sure, you probably won't get punished, but you're not gonna learn. That's what I believe, at least. That's why I jump out of, I don't know, probably less than 10 times that entire FT10. So, yeah, good games. It wasn't as much of a blow as I thought it would be, but it was a good match. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace.